one issue of prophylactics, 3 lipsticks, 3 pair of nylon stockings.
Shoot, a fella could have a pretty good weekend in Vegas with all that stuff.
Gentlemen, you can't fight in here. This is the war room.
Now then, Dimitri, you know how we've always talked about the possibility of something going wrong with the bomb. The bomb, Dimitri. The hydrogen bomb. Well, now, what happened is one of our base commanders, he had a sort of, well, he went a little funny in the head. You know, just a little funny. And he went and did a silly thing. Well, I'll tell you what he did. He ordered his planes to attack your country. Well, let me finish, Dimitri. Let me finish, Dimitri. Well, listen, how do you think I feel about it? Can you imagine how I feel about it, Dimitri? Why do you think I'm calling you? Just to say hello? Of course I like to speak to you. Of course I like to say hello. Not now, but anytime, Dimitri. I'm just calling up to tell you something terrible has happened. It's a friendly call. Of course it's a friendly call. I'm sorry too, Dimitri. I'm very sorry. All right, you're sorrier than I am. But I am sorry as well. I am as sorry as you are, Dimitri. Don't say that you're more sorry than I am, because I'm capable of being just as sorry as you are. So we're both sorry, all right? All right.
Do you realize that fluoridation is the most monstrously conceived and dangerous communist plot we have ever had to face?
Come and play a dead game, soldier. That's nice shooting, soldier. Mandrake, come here.
You calling me, Jack?
Come over here and help me with this fella.
I haven't had very much experience, you know, with those sort of machines, Jack. I've only ever pressed a button in my old Spitfire.
Hendrick, in the name of Her Majesty and the Continental Congress, come here and feed me this bellboy.
Our doomsday scheme cost us just a small fraction of what we've been spending on defense in a single year. But the deciding factor was when we learned that your country was working along similar lines. And we were afraid of a doomsday gap.
This is preposterous. I've never approved of anything like that.
Our source was the New York Times.
I'm a religious man myself, you know, Jack. I believe in all that sort of thing, and I'm hoping, you know, Jack. You dropped your gun, Jack. Yes. You know what I'm... Yeah, no, Jack, let me take that for you. I'll take that for you, Jack. And you know what I'm hoping, Jack? I'm hoping you're going to give me the code, boy. That's what I'm hoping. And, well, you're going to have a little wash and brush up, are you? What a good idea. Always did wonders for a man, that, Jack. A little wash and brush up, water on the back of the neck, and makes you feel marvelous. That's what we need, Jack. Water on the back of the neck and the code. Now, supposing I play a little guessing game with you, Jack boy. I'll try and guess what the code is.
Operator, hold on one. I'll try and keep you a second. Colonel, that Coca-Cola machine, I want you to shoot the lock off it. There may be some change in there.
That's private property.
Colonel, can you possibly imagine what is going to happen to you, your frame outlook, way of life and everything, when they learn that you have obstructed a telephone call to the President of the United States? Can you imagine? Shoot it off! Shoot with a gun! That's what the bullets are for, you twit!
Okay. I'm going to get your money for you. But if you don't get the President of the United States on that phone, you know what's going to happen to you?
What?
You're going to have to answer to the Coca-Cola company.
If the pilot's good, see? I mean, if he's really sharp, he can barrel that baby in solo. I mean, you ought to see it sometime. It's a sight. A big plane, like a 52 room. There's jet exhaust, frying chickens in the barnyard.
Yeah, but has he got a chance?
Has he got a chance? Hell, yeah.
Stay on the bomb run, Ace. I'm going down below and see what I can do.
Roger. Target distance, 3 miles.
Roger, 3 miles.
Target in sight.
Hey, what about Major Kong?
Mr. President, I would not rule out the chance to preserve a nucleus of human specimens. It would be quite easy. At the bottom of some of our deeper mine shafts.
How long would you have to stay down there?
I would think that possibly 100 years.
You mean people could actually stay down there for 100 years?
It would not be difficult, mein Führer. Nuclear reactors could... I'm sorry, Mr. President. Nuclear reactors could provide power almost indefinitely. Greenhouses could maintain plant life. Animals could be bred and slaughtered. Quick survey would have to be made of all the available mine sites in the country. But I would guess that dwelling space for several hundred thousand of our people could easily be provided. Of course, it would be absolutely vital that our top government and military men be included to foster and impart the required principles of leadership and tradition.
But look here, Doctor, wouldn't this nucleus of survivors be so grief-stricken and anguished that they'd, well, envy the dead and not want to go on living?
No, sir. Excuse me. Also, when they go down into the mine, everyone would still be alive. There would be no shocking memories. And the prevailing motion will be one of nostalgia for those left behind, combined with a spirit of bold curiosity for the adventure ahead.
Mr. President, we must not allow a mine shaft gap.
Sir, I have a plan. Mein Führer! I can walk!
We'll meet again.